Bowerbirds are renowned for their unique bower building techniques, and they're built with just one goal in mind, to seduce females for mating.
Bowerbirds are the only animal in the world that actually construct a fancy structure that's only used for mating. So think of it as a teenager's car.
And the male bowerbird knows what the ladies like, and he goes to great lengths to decorate his bower and lure them in.
Great bowerbirds have a long avenue made out of sticks, which a female sits inside watching the male display outside. And the male deposits a batch of gravel and snails and things of different sizes, where the small sizes are close to the entrance to the court, and the larger ones gradually get bigger as they go further away from the court.
Professor John Endler has also been seduced by the Australian songbird and has spent decades studying their unique behaviours. And as one of the world's leading evolutionary biologists, his research spans evolution, ecology, and animal behaviour. He has also worked with a variety of species to understand natural selection in the wild, how animals perceive the world, and how colours and vision affects their survival and reproduction.
So I'm interested in what causes animals and plants to have geographic variation in how they appear and how they behave, how they can see and how they can sense the environment, and how they behave in response to various things such as predation and potential mates.
Enthralled by the natural world since he was a child, Professor Endler says studying the bowerbird offered a unique scientific opportunity.
I could do experiments without disturbing the bowerbird. So the bowerbirds actually destroy each other's bowers and steal each other's ornaments. So that means I could do that same thing, but they don't experience anything different, so they can do perfectly natural behavior in the field.
Although he recently retired, Professor Endler says he will continue to research his beloved bowerbirds from his new 50-acre property in southeast Queensland. For his scientific contributions, he's being awarded the inaugural Suzanne Cory Medal.